Your name or that of any of your classmates to be on the top of that arrest warrant piece of paper. Because if somebody's name is on the top of an arrest warrant, their life has just taken a major league turn, has it not? Does anybody disagree with that? I strive very hard as your prosecutor to not sign my name on arrest warrants unless the evidence is really there. Because if I do, I realize I've messed up your life really bad. Now, if you're a high school student and I sign my name on your arrest warrant, what have I done to your life? I've ruined it. Yes, I've messed it up. You can always recover. You can always recover. But you're right, I've messed it up pretty bad. How so? How have I messed it up?
Can't get a job.
Can't get a job. That's a good answer. Who else? There's no wrong answers. Let me hear from you. Louder?
Won't be accepted into the college of your choice.
Won't be able to get into the college of your choice. Correct. Your friends are going to talk about you too, aren't you? Aren't they? Hey, so-and-so got arrested. Did you hear about that? So I've sullied your reputation, haven't I? Nobody wants that. What else have I done? What's going to happen to you? Can you come back to school the next day? Probably not. The school board's probably going to say, you're out. Suspended or expelled. That's not good. You don't want that on your record. What else? Can't go to school, but where can you go? Where do you have to go? You have to go to court. And if you go to court, who do you want by your side? A lawyer. And how much is that lawyer going to cost you? A lot of money. More than a high school kid has, unless you're some kind of an entrepreneur. So the point is, don't find your name or that of your classmate on the top of an arrest warrant, and specifically because you made some kind of a dumb school shooting threat, which is what we're about to talk about this morning. So let's go to the first slide. This was the very first high school shooting. Before most of you were born, I suspect. It happened in suburban Denver, Colorado. It was obviously national news. And our friend Michael Moore, you know who that is? Filmmaker from Flint, went to Davison High School. He made a movie about that called Bowling for Columbine. That was the real first school shooting. Then we had Virginia Tech University. That was when you were younger and born. That guy came and shot up the university. This was a grade school in Connecticut. Terrible, terrible shooting. Little kids. Somebody's little brother, somebody's little sister. Teachers, administrators. And this one you all know about. This is what has caused hundreds of thousands of people to march on Washington, New York, Detroit. There was a small demonstration in downtown Flint Saturday morning. This is what your generation is growing up with. But more importantly, you are becoming the leaders. Your generation is becoming the leaders of saying, enough is enough. We want change. We want things different. We don't want this for our America. We want things to change. And you're leading the way, and I applaud your generation for what you're doing. I think it shows magnificent leadership, and that America has a great future. In our own county, and I forgot to mention this in the last group, so when you talk to your classmates, you can tell them this. Since Parkland, the Genesee County Prosecutor's Office has issued 6 arrest warrants for people like your age group, but nobody from Fenton High School, for issuing school shooting threats. Six, we reviewed probably twice that many. There were six we didn't issue, but six that we did. And some of those youngsters whose name was on the top of the arrest warrant are no longer in school, their names have been sullied, and they're hanging out now at the regional detention center on Pasadena Avenue because they made a school shooting threat. And what I'm doing, and what I have to do, and what is different about today than when I was a kid, or when my own kid, my youngest is 28, when my kids were in high school, what's different today is that every school shooting threat has to be taken seriously, has to be investigated by the police. If something happens in Fenton, Chief Slater and I have talked already, and he knows I would like a full-fledged police investigation, just like it was a murder, just like it was a carjacking, just like it was an armed robbery or a bank robbery. The police are going to come out and gather all the evidence, interview all the witnesses, and bring the case to me for a determination of whether to issue the arrest warrant. If you don't remember anything else from what I said, remember that. It's not a joke. I don't think it's funny. Nobody in law enforcement thinks it's funny. Hopefully, by this point in time, in the wake of Parkland, none of you think it's funny. And you, as the leaders in the school, as the leading generation to take us forward, need to look after all of your classmates and remind them when somebody has an inkling to say something really stupid, or to write something on the blackboard or the whiteboard, or whatever you use nowadays, remind them, remind her, it's not a joke and it's not funny. There's a lot of funny stuff, I love to laugh, but school shooting threats are not funny. Not in 2018. Not funny. Okay. Somebody may say, well, I got a right to say anything I want. I can make a joke if I want, and I can use whatever humor I want to say whatever I want. Because I have the right of free speech. And since when did joking around become a crime? Well, it's a fair point. And in reviewing cases, we certainly take that into consideration. For example, there was a case that came downtown since Parkland in which somebody put out a music video in which there were some types of threats that were made in the music video. And generally speaking, music lyrics are protected by the First Amendment. In that particular case, we didn't charge because it turned out the lyricist didn't exactly write the lyrics himself, and he had done it a year ago. So we had just found out about it, so it wasn't timely. We didn't charge it. But free speech is not without its limits. Those of you who have had government class and heard of Justice Oliver Wendell Holmes, may recall he wrote a famous opinion from the United States Supreme Court that said you cannot falsely shout fire in a crowded theater. And the point, even though he was overturned and subsequent opinions changed that opinion, the point is well taken. There are certain legal limits to everything. And you can't just say whatever you want to say, whenever you want to say it. And you can't just tweet whatever you want to tweet or put on Facebook. In Michigan, as in most states, we have laws that make it a crime to make false reports or threats to harm others. And that's the law. MCL, Michigan Compiled Law 750.543M, makes it a terrorist, making a terrorist threat or false report of terrorism. It's illegal to threaten to commit an act of terrorism and communicate that threat to any other person. It's illegal to knowingly make a false report of an act of terrorism and communicate the false report to any other person knowing the report is false. Writing a message on a whiteboard that you're going to shoot up the school is a violation of that law. Posting on Facebook that you're going to shoot, forgive me, the principal is a crime. It's a terrorist act. Tweeting that you have a hit list and you're going to kill certain people is a terrorist act and a crime under that statute. Now, you saw the slide, it's not a joke. Saying that you're just joking around is not a defense to this law. Here's the statute. It's not a defense to a prosecution under this section that the defendant did not have the intent or the capability of committing the act of terrorism. And finally, I'm going to talk more about that in a minute, but I want you to see the penalty for this. Up to 20 years in prison. Serious stuff, right? Anybody signing up for 20 years in prison? I don't think so. Let's go back to number two for a moment. It's not a defense. What does that mean legally? This is what it means legally. So, let's say you do something really stupid and you get charged with this. And you've got a lawyer. You've got a great lawyer. You've got F. Lee Bailey. You don't know who that is, but in my generation, he was a great lawyer. Your lawyer's sitting in going to court and says, Your Honor, Mr. Layton has charged my client with a 20-year felony. But my client didn't mean it. My client was just a sophomore at Fenton High School. My client had no more ability to shoot up that school than you or I did. He's so frail and weak, he can't even lift a gun, an assault rifle. He can't do anything. He couldn't have done it in his wildest dreams. Well, because it says it's not a defense that the defendant did not have the intent or capability, this is what the judge is going to do. The judge is going to say, sit down, counselor. As you well know under the statute, I didn't mean it. It was just a joke. It's not a defense. Therefore, you can't even bring that up when I bring the jury in. It's not a defense. The jury will not hear that your client was incapable of committing this grievous offense. Hopefully you have a better defense than that, because under our law, which we have to follow, that's not a defense. Okay, the lawyer now has a bigger hill to climb, does she not? I know that things are different. They just are. We are in a time, 2018, where I have to take these threats seriously. And I think that's what you want me to do. I think you all want to come to a school that's safe. You want to come to a school that you don't have to worry about is going to be evacuated, or somebody's going to come in guns blazing, or you're going to have a drill to go out, not come back, or some greatly anticipated event that you're all looking forward to gets canceled because some idiot wrote something on a blackboard, a whiteboard. Now, when I was young, I didn't have to worry about that. When my kids were young, we didn't worry about it. But this is 2018. Things are different today. And we have to worry about this because in America, where we have great freedoms, unlike most places in the world, this is one of the prices we pay for the great freedoms that we enjoy. And if we have to be more vigilant in policing these types of potential crimes, that's what we need to do. You all need to help. You all are the leaders. You all are the ones who can make sure that your classmates don't do anything that's going to land their name on the top of that arrest warrant. So I'm not here to discuss gun control or other specific measures. I leave that to others. I'm here to make sure none of you do something that you will later regret, because there's just so many consequences of these threats. You start with fear. You have fear among the student body, among the faculty, among the administration. You can have a SWAT team just descend on your school all of a sudden, and it'll disrupt your routine. Hundreds of you will be thrown out of the school and into the streets. All this money that the government has to pay out to protect you can be averted if everybody just does the smart thing. And you look out for each other. I can't emphasize that enough. You all know who amongst you is likely to do something like this. You all are the ones who can say, you know, give them a little elbow, give her a little elbow and say, don't do that. That's really not going to get us anywhere. If you've got issues, let me help you in some other way. Look out for your fellow classmates. Look out for your fellow Fenton High School students. Because you know they're going to get suspended, expelled, charged with a crime. Nothing good is going to happen. Now, when the chief brings cases to me, or any chief from any jurisdiction, I want you to know we're doing this all over the county. Fenton High School is not being singled out. This is a magnificent school. This is a school that I think is one of the leading high schools in the state of Michigan. And I think you're looked upon like that. And it's a reflection of the student body. A lot of great kids in this school who are going to do a lot of great things in their lives. But you can start, you can continue by doing these things here to help some of your classmates who may need a boost up, who may need a little, you know, kick in the ass, if you will. So we're going to look at, when the chief brings cases down to me, we're going to look at the student's disciplinary history. I want to know how that kid's been doing in high school so far with respect to how do they get along with the classmates, how do they get along with the teachers. Have they been in trouble before? What is their relationship with fellow students and teachers? What's their home life? What's the family structure? What are the family dynamics? Is there parental oversight? Is there drug or alcohol abuse? Is there domestic violence issues? I'm going to look into all that. I'm going to want to know if there's guns in the homes. Does the child in question have access to those guns? And do they use them? I want to know the impact on the specific target. Does the state victim have some kind of an ongoing feud with the suspect? Does the intended victim live in fear? Or have some kind of anxiety that something might actually happen? I want to know about the student's mental history or parent mental state. Believe it or not, prosecutors, including yours truly, I have a heart. Or I have a heart in here. I don't just sign my name on arrest warrants. I'd rather not. If somebody's got issues, I want to know about it because maybe we can get them help. We have a mental health court downtown. And it's not a stigma on somebody to have mental health issues. Many, many people have them. I'm sure you're all aware of the opioid issue going on across the country. Many of those people are not criminals. They have a health issue. They need help. And when politics aside, when the president calls for the death penalty for drug cases, I was asked by PBC 12 what I thought. And I said, it's not a criminal issue. You don't put to death somebody who has a health issue. You help them. You get them off the drugs. You get them off the opioids. Same thing here. If somebody's got a mental health issue, I want to know about it because that may enable me to help them. And finally, the students expressed intent after the incident's discovery. Are they claiming it's just a joke? Were they, in fact, able to carry out the threat? Obviously, somebody who's able to carry out the threat is going to be looked at more harshly than somebody who's not. But that doesn't mean the person who couldn't carry it out still didn't commit the crime. So the Attorney General runs a program called OK Say. How many of you have heard of it? How many of you have the app on your phone? Okay, well, there's an app. Put it on your phone. It's totally anonymous. If you make a report, your name does not have to be attached. Your name will not be attached. If you know about a depression issue, if it's you or somebody else, if you know about a bullying issue, and a bullying can lead to a lot of these school threats, there's a lot of kids in school who feel bullied. And I hope you'll step in, and I hope you'll help the youngster who feels bullied. Okay to Say is a place to report that bullying. Same thing with family issues, same thing with mental health issues. It's about early intervention and prevention that can stop some of these school shooting threats and many other problems. Conclusion. School officials should never ignore the signs of danger. And I'm happy to say that Fenton High School, your administrators and your teachers have always stepped up. They don't ignore it, nor should they. That's our message to all districts across the country. Parents must be involved in their children's lives and be alert to changes. And obviously, and hopefully, you can talk to your folks if you have issues. There has to be ongoing communication between teachers, administrators, parents, school counselors, law enforcement. We should all be at the table. That's one of the reasons I'm here today. I'm at the table. I want to be part of the solution. I don't want to sign my name on any arrest warrants for Fenton High School kids. The police, as you now know, are encouraged to take all incidents at face value, do a complete police investigation, and report it to me. And when I deem it appropriate, as the chief law enforcement officer of Genesee County, violators will be charged and prosecuted under the law. I appreciate your attentiveness this morning. I hope you have a great spring break. And go Tigers. Thank you.
Thank you, Prosecutor Layton, for being here today. Thank you all for being a great audience. A lot of food for thought. You may not have the opportunity today in SRT, but please go back to your classes, talk to your classmates about the information that they may have heard right now or earlier today. Have a great spring break. Come back to your SRT.